welcome to That's Showbiz. This is the quiz show that covers showbiz from A to Z with celebrities who know showbiz from A to B. Now, we have the same team captains each week on this programme, and the first person I'd like to introduce to you, between us, we have enough metal in us to make a whole new Skoda. Gloria Hunniford.
Thank you. My metal is all locked away somewhere in here. People say it's my best break yet. But I think actually this program is going to be just fab because I have a great team tonight. In actual fact, you know, people say on a program like this, first of all, they say, how do you choose them? And then they say, why do you choose them? Well, it's very straightforward when they're witty and talented and erudite like Joan Collins and Richard Attenborough. But what can you say when a Sue Pollard and Richard O'Sullivan?
I think she likes them. She's playing the part of the one-armed bandit on this show, and over here, El Bandito Teenager.
Hello. Not many people know this, but Mike Smith's father invented the rear-view mirror, and he's never looked back. Well, folks, I went to the ends of the earth to get my team, which was a bit of a waste of time because they only live around the corner. Tibra Taylor, Maris Hughes!
Round one of our contest, there's 2 points for a correct answer, 1 point if a member of your team has to help you out with it. This is going to individual members of teams. Easy for me, because I've got them written down. The only difficult bit in the whole of this round are the answers. Gloria Hunniford, 2 clips for you to enjoy briefly, because there will be questions afterwards.
People are dying. Is that an argument in favour of sitting on cats?
We don't have a cat, do we?
We have a cat. That is to say, I have a cat.
This guy is gonna give me some money.
Yeah, but you wouldn't use it to buy arms, would you, Wolfie?
No, well, we'll get the jag first.
Yeah.
Gloria,
oh, I'm
first
trying
of all,
to write with my left hand. It's not easy.
You saw Citizen Smith.
I
that
did.
Last clip there. Who played Citizen Smith?
Oh, I did an interview with him not all that long ago. Robert Lindsay played
Robert
Citizen
Lindsay
Smith.
Is correct, yes. And in the other one, which was Fortunes of War, who played Kenneth Branagh's wife?
Yeah. Emma Thompson.
Emma Thompson. Robert yeah. Lindsay and Emma Thompson. Correct answer there. 2 points. Now, another 2 points. Which stage musical did they appear in together?
Well, I tell you, I was going to say this right at the top of the programme. I was almost going to say there's a big link because they played in Me and My Girl.
They did. 2 points.
And this lady played in Me and My Girl on stage. And he plays in Me and My Girl, and he plays in Me and My Girl as well on the telly.
Yeah.
Yes, that was the 3rd question, Gloria.
And I actually had thought of introducing them like that, and I almost didn't.
What is the connection between Me and My Girl and the 3 of the team members seated here?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, maximum of 6 points for Gloria. And good, we move over to Kenny Everett. See whether you can telepathically glean the questions from me, Kenny. A soap
what?
Opera from the
Don't
60s.
Don't live around the corner. What?
a soap opera from the 60s called Compact.
Oh, Compact.
I'm sorry, it's just that I find it difficult to take this seriously.
Oh, hi, Ian. What's all this about some stolen jewellery? Somebody caught up to me at last? Light-fingered bishop, the hook and ladder man? Come on, arrest
me. May I introduce Mr. Burling from Scotland Yard?
Oh, Scotland Yard.
Mr. Burling's here on business in connection with some stolen jewellery.
Well, shall I go out and come in again?
Hmm. Now, you no doubt recognise the tall one there.
Well, I recognise all of them, because, I mean, I come from before black and white. I was around when it was just black.
Ronald Allen played the editor of Compact the magazine, Ian Harmon.
2 points.
Thank you. Thank you. That puts me in 2nd place at the moment, and you in 3rd. What other soap did he go on to star in?
Oh, he did Oodles All Over Coronation. No, not Crossroads Motel.
Crossroads, yeah. Yes, he played David Hunter.
That's right.
In Crossroads. Yes. And what
he
was
came
the
round to our house once.
And there's one with one name, too, one name.
What is the name of the Australian actor in that clip?
His second name's Kerr, and he wears corks.
Bill Kerr
yeah, is correct, yes. Yeah. Now take a look at this short clip coming up from Compact. The lady on the right of it is Frances Bennett, playing Gussie. Mm-hmm. But do you recognise, has she been round to your house, the lady in glasses playing Camilla Hope?
White lilacs,
What am I going to do?
Well, send it back if it embarrasses you.
Well?
Well, do you want him to stop pestering you, or don't you?
Oh, it's Rain, isn't it? Carmen.
Carmen Silvera.
Yes. Hello.
And she plays...
Hello.
Rennie's wife, Edith, in Hello, Hello. Yes, right. 2 points, maximum
very
points.
Right. Very good.
Well done.
Very good.
OK, six all as we go across to Sue Pollard for her first question this evening. Who are you seeing and who are you hearing? Who did you see, first of all, Sue?
John Travolta.
And
Gene Kelly.
Correct for 2 points. Who did you hear?
Olivia Newton-John.
Correct for 2 points.
Or Neutron Bomb. Yeah.
And in which films did Olivia Newton-John star with John Travolta and also with Gene Kelly?
Oh, yes.
Two separate films.
One was Grease, with the John Travolta link-up.
That's it.
And the Gene Kelly one... I shall have to consult with my...
I
think it might have been Xanadu, because he taught her to dance.
It was Xanadu, but I'll give you 1 point because you got help from the team on
that. Oh, I shouldn't have then. Oh, yeah, but that was
all the time.
I knew I shouldn't have to.
But I'll give you a point back because you also appeared in a stage version of Grease, didn't you?
Oh, yes, I was Cha Cha Di Gregorio, the blind date.
Yes.
And what did you sing in there?
Yes, well, that's got to be worth a point, I suppose, hasn't it? Right, anyway, Neris Hughes, can you name the people that you see and hear?
I want you. I want you. I want you so bad. Honey, I want you.
Who did you see?
Dylan.
Dylan the Rabbit?
Dylan the Rabbit.
From the Magic Roundabout?
Yes.
Yes, and you heard?
Bob Dylan the singer.
Bob Dylan the singer, yes, that's 4 points so far. Now, which of your countrymen gave both the singer and the rabbit their names?
Dylan Thomas.
Dylan Thomas. Robert Zimmerman became Bob Dylan because of his respect for Dylan Thomas. Dylan the Rabbit was named after Bob.
Do we get a point if we have a connection with one of their questions?
No.
Because Emma Thompson's father did the voice for Magic Roundabout and the script.
Ooh.
Oh.
Difficult.
1 point off for being a smart boy. Yay! But you can earn that point back if you can name this man. I want his complete name, including his middle name.
And I want his address.
Dylan.
Dylan, because
it's gotta be. I don't know.
It is, because he's such a fan of Bob Dylan that he adopted his name and became Bob Dylan Willis.
Higher in my estimation.
Let's go to Richard O'Sullivan, then. It's 13 to 12 at the moment. You're 1 point behind, Richard. Can you identify this couple?
Love is great. A lot of people make more games.
Who are the couple who can't spell Caesar?
Well, he's the mayor of some town in America called Cher and Sonny. Sonny and Cher.
He's Sonny, yes. She's Cher. Sonny and Cher. Before they became famous, they made records as Caesar and Cleo. 2 points. Who played Caesar and Cleo in the film Cleopatra?
Well, I should know this because I, in fact, played Cleopatra's brother called King Ptolemy. Sorry, Mike. And that is Rex Harrison and beautiful Elizabeth Taylor.
You have 4 maximum points on that. Well done, Richard O'Sullivan. Let's go to Tim Brook Taylor, or even Tim Brook Taylor.
Brock, I prefer the Brock.
Tim Dillon Taylor.
Ah.
A clip from the golden or the almost silver-plated days of television just for you.
Oh! I thought you'd given that up.
I just did that to pass the time.
Well, I think it might be a nice thing to go to Tahiti.
Ah, you read about it.
I have read about it. That's where the women wear grass skirts.
And all the men have got lawnmowers.
That's it!
You obviously saw Jimmy Edwards there and Ted Ray on Does the Team Think?
Oh, that was that bang goes my answer, yes.
Well, you did host the show on television a few years later, but in those days, who was the question master?
I didn't know they'd done it. On radio, it was, MacDonald Hobley, nice man.
MacDonald Hobley, 2 points.
Was he on television? Oh, didn't know that.
Can you name these other two members of the panel?
Oh, yes, two men I owe a lot to, actually. Bernard Braden on the right, who should be doing that to life, and on the left is Frank Muir.
That's absolutely correct. For two maximum points, you have 4 points on that score there. That brings us up to the end of round one. And just behind on 16, it's Gloria Hannaford's team, but a point in front on 17, Kenny Everett. Hey. Well, as if there weren't enough already, we're now going to get some laughs into this programme. We're going to look at some comedy now for round two. Sue Pollard.
Oh, lovely.
The show is Dad's Army. The characters are Captain Mannering, Sergeant Wilson, and Private Pike. So you get no points for getting any of those. Instead, watch this extract, and when it finishes, can you tell us, what does Mannering say to Pike?
Right.
Number, please.
Warmington on sea. I've forgotten the number.
Freeze frame. What does Mannering say next?
Stupid boy.
Let's see.
You stupid boy. It's Warmington on sea.
Well done. 2 points there. Now, if you're hoping to earn points by identifying Arthur Lowe as Mannering and John Le Mesurier as Wilson, you're disappointed. Because what I want to know instead for 2 points is, why did BBC bosses think that the writers Jimmy Perry and David Croft had made a mistake in casting those two?
Oh dear.
They wrote you.
Well,
series,
it could be anything, though.
They asked for money.
They probably.
They wrote your Heidi.
Yeah, they did. I suspect. No, I don't know. I suppose it's probably because they probably thought they should play the parts the other way around.
Dead right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
They thought that the upper class Le Mesurier should play the officer, and they also thought the jumped up bank manager should be the sergeant.
Oh, great. Well.
And they're completely against the type.
Oh, marvellous.
Now, here comes your easy point.
I thought that was it.
You mean there's more?
Yep. Who played the stupid boy?
Oh, Ian Lavender.
Ian Lavender is correct. Oh, yes, well done. Maximum points there for Sue Pollard. Neris Hughes, a cliffhanger coming up for you.
Ooh. Just hold on to my legs. Hold my feet.
Michael Crawford in Some Others Do Have Him There, hanging around. Who played his wife, Betty?
Michel Dutrice.
Michel Dutrice is correct for 2 points. Who is Michel Dutrice's actor husband?
The American.
Edward Woodward. And points for anybody on your team who can do an impersonation of Frank Spencer.
Oh, Betty, I think I did a whoopsie.
Good. Okay, one more point for that. Richard O'Sullivan.
Yes.
If I said Paul Eddington as Jim Hacker and Nigel Hawthorne as Sir Humphrey, what would you say?
Two very fine actors.
And you'd say yes, Minister.
And I'd say, of course, yes, Minister.
Or yes, Prime Minister.
Or yes, Prime Minister.
Yep, we can now watch Jim Hacker, who's been in office for 3 days, and he's now handed out his first political honours.
I meant to give a peerage to Ron Jones, not Ron Jones.
Well, what are we going to do about Ron Jones's peerage? Give him one too?
With respect, Prime Minister, we can't send two Lord Ron Jones to the upper house. It'd look like a job lot.
Got to give him something, I promised.
Well, what's he interested in? Does he watch television?
He hasn't even got a set.
Fine, make him a governor of the BBC.
Richard O'Sullivan. Don't laugh at that one, please. Don't laugh at that gag. Who plays the Prime Minister's aide, Bernard?
Yeah. It is, isn't it?
I'm sure it's him, yeah.
I wasn't conferring. I was just, you know,
of course,
Derek Folds.
Derek Folds is correct for 2 points. Which cunning character did he assist before moving to number 10? Boom, boom.
Oh, yes.
Basil. Basil, boom, boom. Brush.
Basil, yes. You can confer on this round.
Oh, I see. Basil Brush.
Basil Brush is the correct answer. So you have maximum 6 points on that. Well done, Richard. Timbrook Taylor.
Name dropper.
Two heads with but a single thought. Mr. Laurel and Mr. Hardy.
Oh,
Thank you, boys. Where'll you be when I need you?
Right here.
Okay.
Which one of them was born Arthur Jefferson in the north of England?
That was Stan Laurel.
Stan Laurel. And what did Ollie Hardy always say when one of Stan's schemes went wrong?
That's another fine mess you've got.
He's not
me.
Irish.
Another fine mess you've got me in.
Two. In two.
Two.
Yes. 4 points, maximum score. Gloria Hannaford.
All right.
Now for an Irish joke, or rather, a joke from an Irishman.
The crown carried by the senior cardinal is symbolically placed on his head. The Holy Roman Church now acknowledges its new shepherd and spiritual leader.
That was, of course, Dave Allen, who has a catchphrase to end his shows. What is it?
At least I've got one hand to do this, and he'd say, "May your God go with you." And he raised the glass.
2 points, correct.
And I won't tell you an Irish joke, you'll be awfully glad to hear.
which Irish comedian's catchphrase is, "It's the way I tell them."
No, you didn't say that right, Mike. "It's the way I tell them," is really how you should have said it. And it's Frank Carson.
32 points so far to Gloria's team, 26 to Kenny's team. You've got some catching up to do here, Kenny. A clip from a recently released video of a fairly recent movie. It's The Three Amigos. It stars Steve Martin, Chevy Chase, and Martin Short.
Riding six white horses when she comes. She'll be riding six white horses when she comes. She'll be riding six white horses. She'll be riding six white horses. She'll be riding six white horses when she comes.
Excuse me.
Come on.
Are you the singing bush?
Follow the sea with a yeho. We'll blow the man down. Oh, pay attention and listen.
Let
to me.
Let me talk to him. Excuse us. Are you the singing bush?
Yeho. Blow the man down. Merrily we roll.
Forget
along,
it.
Roll
my
along,
guess is this is the singing bush.
So, you know the film's title and the names of the stars.
You can ask me what happens next.
No. Who plays the part of the bush?
Oh, please.
Oh, come on.
He's just an American singer-songwriter. He upset a lot of people of restricted growth with a show called Short People.
That's Randy Newman. Randy Newman.
Randy Newman, give you that for 2 points. Mm. And so at the end of round two, we have, just creeping up behind Gloria Hannaford, Kenny Everett in with 30 points. But leading with 32, it is glorious. And so we rush desperately towards round three. Each team is now going to see a montage of six show business policemen. Or to put it another way, top of the cops.
Oh my God.
At the same time, they will hear two pieces of music. And working together, they've got to name the cops and the series they starred in. And they've got to identify the music. Kenny's team first. Yeah. How many can you get? Pens and papers ready.
The Teddy Boys ain't partial to me company. They don't like all their capers to be seen by an ordinary copper who's patrolling his beat around Dog Green.
Painful round. We want the actors' names and the film or series they starred in. We'll go through them one by one, starting with cop number one, who was?
Steve McQueen.
In
Bullet.
Correct. Number two.
Angie Dickinson.
As policewoman?
Policewoman or Sergeant Pepper Anderson. Yes, 2 points. Three.
Richard Harris.
In?
It's not Sherlock Holmes. The
Streets of Soho. There's something about Soho.
No, after the other side for 1 point.
Poirot. Which one is?
Not Poirot, no, but Maigret it
was. Oh, Maigret, yes. Of course.
Mm. Number four.
Glynis Barber.
As in Make Peace.
Which one was she?
The female one.
Pretty bold guess, that.
Make Peace,
yes. Number five.
John Thor.
In
Inspector Morse.
Correct, 2 points. Number six.
John Nettles.
John Nettles, he played my lover in Live the Birds.
Lucky yes, you. But, so you got almost maximum points there. Let's go for what you heard.
Dixon of Doc Green, Jack
Sung
Warner.
By Jack Warner, yeah. Yes.
And Sting, I'll Be Watching You.
Yeah, or The Police, Every Breath You Take, okay. Which, yes, had the liners anyway. Yeah. Almost maximum points for you, Kenny's team there. Let's move over to Gloria's side. Your turn to name as many of these showbiz cops as possible, and the name of the character they play, all the series they starred in. Watch.
paints 1,000 words, then why can't I paint you? The words will never show the you I've come to know.
Okay,
we need to
go through them one by one. Name the star and the cop he plays, number one.
All right, well, it was Clint Eastwood and Dirty Harry.
Yeah, what's the cop?
Oh, the cop. Oh, yes.
Oh dear. I think it was Harry. I don't know his name.
Sergeant Dirty Harry.
Sergeant Dirty
Gallagher.
Yeah, Gallagher. Yes, right. Yes. So we said Dirty Harry.
Yes. Two.
It was Cagney Lacey and his Tyne Daly.
Which one was she?
Oh, yes. She was. Hang on a minute. Oh, crikey.
Cagney, you got a one in two chance of getting it.
One or other, Cagney.
She wasn't Cagney. She was Lacey.
Lacey. Oh, rubbish. You can't offer that.
Well, 1 point to Kenny's team. Three.
It's Juliet Bravo.
And the actress?
The series, Anna Carteret.
Correct for 2 points. Four.
Peter Falk.
As?
Columbo.
Columbo.
Correct. Number five.
It was Softly, Softly.
Yeah. Frank Windsor.
Detective Sergeant John Watt.
Right.
Six.
And it's Raymond Burr and Ironside.
That's correct. Let's go on to what you heard.
Sue's department.
Well, we heard the Laughing Policeman there.
By?
Well, you see, it could be anybody, really. Let's face it.
It could be Dennis Waterman.
Yeah. Yes. Point to the Laughing Policeman. Anybody know who the Laughing Policeman was or who sung it?
George Robey.
No.
Oh, it's a good try, though.
Very good try. Who was George Robey?
It was
Charles Penrose.
Yeah.
Right. And secondly, you heard?
Well, we heard Telly Savalas, who played Kojak.
Yeah. And he was singing...
Who sang, If a picture paints 1,000 words.
If
would have done.
Well done.
At the end of round three, you won't believe this, but it's a draw so far. 46 points each. And round four coming up now. This is where it's going to sort it all out in 90 seconds. Each team has 15 quick questions coming up to put them on the spot. To each team member, I will ask the question. If they can't answer it and they get help from another team member, we halve the score down to 1 point. So 2 points up for grabs on each correct answer. You have 90 seconds. Gloria's team will start with now. And Sue Pollard, 90 seconds. Who sang about Fat Bottom Girls?
Fat Bottom Girls? Pass.
Queen was the answer. Richard, which Queen starred Humphrey Bogart and Katharine Hepburn?
The boat.
The African Queen, 1 point. Gloria, the star who played Queen Christina wanted to be alone. Who was she?
Oh, Greta Garbo.
Greta Garbo is correct. Sue, who was known as the King of Rock and Roll?
Elvis Presley.
Elvis Presley is correct. Richard, Clark Gable was known as the King of...
Sex.
No, Hollywood. Roughly the same sort of thing. Gloria, which king made records as Nemo, Saccharin and the Weatherman?
Oh, that guy who writes a column. Jonathan King.
Jonathan King
moon, yes.
Is correct. Sue, which king's daughters were Goneril, Regan and Cordelia?
Pass.
Yes, King Lear. Richard, who played the king in the movie The King and I?
Yul Brynner.
Yul Brynner's correct. Gloria, which king was Fay Wray's co-star? You got 30 seconds.
Oh, he held King Kong.
King Kong, correct. Sue, who had a hit with Say I'm Your Number One?
Pass.
Princess. Richard, which princess starred in High Society?
Grace Kelly.
Correct. Gloria, how is pop star Rogers Nelson better known?
Rogers Nelson.
Oh, 3 seconds. It's Prince.
All are consisted of animals. And we have no chance there. Flipping King Kong.
Well, Prince's lawyer will be seeing to Sue Pollard later on. 13 points on that. That gives them 59. 46 points. You've got 13 to catch up, 14 to win. Here we go. Kenny Everett's team, 90 seconds, starting with Neris Hughes. In a film starring John Denver and George Burns, what divinity did Burns play?
God.
God. It was given by Tim, 1 point. Which rock musician is known as God? Tim.
What's his name? The Boss.
No.
Pass.
Eric Clapton. Kenny, Clapton dedicated a hit song to Patty Harrison and recorded it as Derek and the Dominoes. What's the title?
Layla.
Neris, Layla Williams and Christopher Trace were the first presenters of which children's television show?
Blue Peter?
An answer you'd already prepared. Yes, Tim, in which film did P.C. George Dixon get killed? You have a minute.
Dixon of Doc Green?
No, film.
Film.
Blue Lamp.
Blue Lamp.
Kenny, the actor who killed Dixon later died in Venice. Who was he?
Oh, victim.
45 seconds left. Dirk Bogarde is correct. 1 point. Neris, which Venetian moneylender was played on stage by both Dustin Hoffman and Laurence Olivier? Shylock, correct. Tim, in which film did Hoffman and Olivier star together?
Marathon Man.
Correct. Kenny, in which musical did one of them appear as a hologram?
The big, loud thing. Time.
Time. Neris, at what time did the train carrying Pete Murray, Joe Douglas and Freddie Mills arrive?
6:05 special.
Correct. Tim, which train has Ringo Starr's voice?
Thomas the Tank Engine.
Correct. Kenny, which choo-choo left from track 29?
The Chattanooga one.
Correct. Neris, who played Glenn Miller on film? 5 seconds.
Oh, Jimmy Stewart.
Correct. Tim, what was the name of James Stewart's giant invisible rabbit?
Harvey.
Woo! A round. What a round.
Good match.
It was a grand round from Gloria Hannaford's team. It gave them 59 points, but it gave them second place. So well done to
they
Sue Pollard
well.
And Richard O'Sullivan and Gloria Hannaford. But an absolutely scintillating last round there for Tim Brooke Taylor, for Neris Hughes and Kenny Everett. 66 points, this week's winners. Out of time. But that, as they say, is showbiz. We'll see you soon.
And in fact, Mike Smith will be back next Saturday at the earlier time of 6:35.